Good morning students, welcome you all in English class. Today I am going to teach you an interesting story, Chandni, which is lesson number 7 from your An Alien Handbook. This story is written by Zakir Hussain. The main character of this story is Abu Khan, who was an old man who lived in Almora Hills. He is very lonely, he didn't have any children, he was very fond of taming goats. He gave very funny name to his goats like Kalwa, Mungia, Gujri. He provided them very fresh and juicy food to eat. Though he showered all his love and affection on his goats, all his goats left Abu Khan one by one. Why did they all leave him? Do you know? Because they all love their freedom. This is the main theme of the story. So let's enjoy reading this story in details. This story is about Abu Khan and his freedom-loving goats. Abu Khan lived in Almora Hills, Uttarakhand, with his pets, goats. He treated them like his own children and he often talked to them like human beings. He took them grazing during the day. At night, he tied them with a rope in his in the pole of his compound. Although Abu Khan loved his goat and fed them well, they did not like being tied up because the goats like the freedom. They loved to be free. So one by one they left him and went away to the hilltop, which they used to stir during the morning hours. Abu Khan felt sad because he knew that the wolf would eat them, because he knew there was wolf in that hilltop who would eat and who would kill his goats. After all, his goats had left him. Abu Khan decided not to have any pets because one by one all of them have left Abu Khan, which made him really sad, very sad. He showered all his love to his goats, but they all did not care Abu Khan, and after giving warning also they all left him and went to the hills because they all love their freedom. They want to enjoy their freedom in the hilltop. Abu Khan decided not to have any more pets, but he missed living with his goats so much that he got a beautiful white little goat one day. He was very sad. He decided not to bring any goats, but he felt very lonely, miserable. He missed all his goats, so he decided to bring very young goat. And it was very beautiful white little goat. He named her Chandini. He shared all the stories of his dear friends with her. For many years, Chandini lived happily with Abu Khan. Chandini was fascinated by the beauty of the sun shining on the hills and the breeze blowing through the trees. Chandini also goes for grazing in the daytime with Abu Khan, but in the night, Chandini was also tied up on the pole with the rope. Chandini loved to see the hilltop, which was shining on the sun, the beauty of the sun shining on the hilltop. This is really attracted Chandini. She loved to see the sun shining on the hilltops and the cold wind breezing over there. She wondered what it would be like to run up there. She always wished to go to the top hilltops and enjoy running over there with the cold winds. She wanted to be free. Soon she stopped eating grass and listening to Abu Khan's story. Though Abu Khan provided her very good, very fresh foods, Chandini lost all her interest in the food and in the story of Abu Khan, which she used to hear daily. She even did not like good food, tasty food. One day she requested Abu Khan to set her free so that she could go to the hills. Now Tani again wished the same like her friends. Abu Khan was heartbroken. He was very sad. He warned her that the wolf eat her. But Chandini was determined to have her freedom, because every day she was gazing the hilltops. Every day she was wishing to run there. She loved to be free. So she was determined to have her freedom. She assured Abu Khan that she would use her horns to fight the wolf. She is very brave. She told that I would fight with the wolf with my horns. Abu Khan reminded Chandni that one of his goats named Kalwa had died fighting the wolf, although she was as big as a deer. But this did not change the decision of Abu Khan, decision of Chandini. When Chandini insisted on going to the hills, Abu Khan locked her in a small hut. When Chandini did not listen Abu Khan got angry and he locked Chandini in the small hut. But he forgot to close the window. At night, Chandini escaped from a window that Abu Khan had forgotten to close. She took the benefit of it. And where did she go? She reached to the top of the hill. She played on the green slopes all day long. She refused to join a pack of wild goats because she wanted to enjoy her freedom alone. After reaching to the hilltop, she was running all through the cold winds. The whole day she was running to the field, green field. She was enjoying her freedom. She even did not accept the offer of a pack of wild goats who asked her to join their company. But she did not accept the offer because she wanted to enjoy her freedom alone. When day turned into night, now the whole day has passed and it's night time, everything became very quiet and very dark. Chandini heard a strange grunt and she remembered the wolf Abu Khan had warned her about. She was scared, but she did not want to go to Abu Khan. Chandini decided to fight the wolf. So she fought him all night. She fought with the wolf the whole night. When the morning dawned, Chandini was bleeding heavily from her wounds. The whole day and whole night, Chandini fought with the fierce, dangerous wolf. And when there was morning, Chandini was bleeding heavily from her wounds. The wolf was tired of fighting and was waiting to eat Chandini. Who was looking this all? A flock of birds sitting on a tree were witness to the tough fight between Chandini and the wolf. A wise bird very confidently proclaimed that it was Chandini, not the wolf, who had won the fight. Though Chandini was no more, Chandini was killed by the wolf. But she fought bravely for her freedom to the wolf. And she was the picture of courage. She was very brave. That's why a wise bird very confidently declared that Chandini was a winner. So this was the theme of the story, love for freedom. Students, I hope you understood this story. Read this story from your textbook for better understanding. If you have any doubt, Please share with me. Go through the summary of the chapter once. Abu Khan was an old man. He was living in Almora. He was very fond of having goats as pets. He used to call them by funny names. His goats were of the best heel breed. They were all heel breed birds. Goats. All his goats wanted freedom, but their freedom cost them their lives. All of them were killed by a wolf. Abu Khan was very sad on the demise of his goats. To avoid his loneliness, he decided to bring a very small young goat. He named it Chandni. After growing up, Chandni also wanted freedom. Abu Khan told her about the danger. One day, Chandni managed to run away from Abu Khan's hut and reached the hills. She enjoyed and felt that it was the happiest day of her life. At night, she heard the voice of a wolf and decided to put up a good fight to retain her freedom. The fight starts and ultimately, Chandni was killed by the wolf. So, students, read the story from your textbook. Hope you understood. Thank you very much. Take care. Enjoy study at home. Bye. Thank you.